In this video, I'd like you to learn Patrik Laine's confidence. My name is Jason Yee, this is Train 2.0, and this is a confidence case study of a new hockey wizard. So let's see what Patrik Laine has to say.
There's a conversation going on right now that you've closed the gap on Austin Matthews. How aware are you of that?
I know that the cap is now smaller than like when the season started. So, and I think the cap is now smaller, and hope that I can catch him.
Do you think you can here?
Yeah, I think maybe if I can make it to the World Champions team, so I think it's possible.
I have to say, you're a cool cat here. Really casual about this.
Yeah, I know what I'm capable of, and I know that, and I'm saying that, so I'm not afraid to say it out loud, and I like that myself.
As hockey fans listen to this, they can barely believe their ears. Some might even cringe. First off, is this guy taking the interview lying down? But then they're surprised that he's so certain, so confident in his ability. Now, hockey players are almost better than politicians when it comes to deflecting answers about their confidence. Listen as Sidney Crosby obviously and openly deflects a question aimed at uncovering his confidence.
Do you have to manage any expectations, Sid? Because, I mean, when this team has a healthy Sidney Crosby and a healthy Evgeny Malkin and the depth that you have, I mean, obviously people are going to think that you guys are going to do some pretty special things. Do you have to manage those expectations or temper them at all?
Yeah, well, I think, we all want to execute as best we can every game. So I think early on there might be some things that, you know, hopefully become pretty easy as far as habits and things like that that might be a little bit tougher to do this time of year. But, you know, as far as expectations, I think they're always going to be high. There's nothing wrong with that. And hopefully that brings the best out of us. But, we've just got to focus on how we play.
Remember, what was the question again? Did Crosby answer it? No. So this is part of the hockey narrative. Hockey players are notably humble, but almost to a fault. They end up saying a bunch of words that don't have any meaning. At Train 2.0, we like to call this droning. That's when you say words, but the words don't have meaning. Drone coaches, of course, do this all the time, but Don Cherry gives the thumbs up for those anyway. Now, let's get back to Laine.
It's part of who I am, and it's a big part of my game that I have confidence, and I know what I'm capable of and how good I am, and I think that's not a bad thing. But I think people can think what they want, but I think I know how good I am, and I'm not afraid to say it. I don't know. I just like to tell jokes and that kind of stuff. And I don't really think about it. I was just like to say those kind of things and try to be funny and just that's who I am. And I don't want to change that.
You're not joking. That's how confident you are.
Yeah, you could say that. I know if I get that kind of spot 100 times, there's a good chance that I can score a lot of goals from the spot, so I'm not afraid to say that.
So here we see a little bit behind the curtain into Laine's confidence. We see two things. The first is clarity. He says near the end, very clearly, that he knows if he is in that spot, he will score 99 times out of 100. Now, that's not really being boastful. That is rock solid clarity. He knows the spot and he's clear that he can score 99 times out of 100. The next thing that we see is that he makes statements that are tongue-in-cheek. He says this. He's having fun. He's playing a game. The fact that he's able to be light and play games speaks to his confidence. And because he's playing a game that he's chosen the rules of, he's in control. So you might see that that's similar to another athlete who's in the limelight right now, Conor McGregor.
Just through years in the gym, through wins, through losses, through life, I just realized that if you say it to yourself and you look yourself in the eye and look yourself in the mirror and truly, truly believe that not a man alive can beat you, then that is the way it is. And just through hours in the gym and preparation, I feel that I am untouchable right now.
You might notice how McGregor and Laine can both make matter-of-fact statements about their ability and then just let it sit there. This shows rock-solid confidence because they have clarity in their ability and they understand how their statement is going to be received. They're in control. They've chosen the rules of the game. Now, we've talked about how Laine is in control because he is having fun and playing a game. So let's see how McGregor is playing a game. His cockiness in this clip here is tongue-in-cheek.
So if you want to move up, I'm here. It's going to be easy money.
That wasn't the question, but ask yourself truthfully. If Dana rang you and said, you don't have to fight Cerrone, you can fight McGregor, even though Cerrone was still fit, would you take it? You're damn right you take it.
Of course, man. Easy because money. Of course you got easy money, man.
I can make you rich.
You,
I change your bum life. You fight me, it's a celebration.
Of course you can. I would beat you.
When you sign to fight me, it's a celebration. You ring back home. You ring your wife. Baby, we done it. We're rich, baby. Conor McGregor made us rich. Break out the red panties. We're rich, baby. So don't say you would not take that fight because you would take that fight like everyone else up here would take the fight against me if it was offered, regardless of belts or any of that shit.
So look who's playing the game. Look who's chosen the rules of the game, McGregor. Look who's having more fun, McGregor. And he has complete control because even the guy who tried trash-talking him is laughing. Now, does this remind you of another player who mastered clarity and control and therefore confidence? How about Chris Pronger? First off, he hit Justin Bieber into the boards, which that was hilarious. But second, watch as he pulls back his curtain on his mental warfare tactics, on where his confidence comes from.
You know, the only people that really matter are the guys in the room. They don't seem to mind the way I play. I maybe missed his hand and got his foot, but there's a good chance that may have happened. I think it's just, you try to get in guys' heads early.
Pronger doesn't just leave a mark physically, he plays mind games just as hard.
There weren't too many stories about the games. It was all about this puck that was taken from the ice.
Who steals pucks after games?
I think he was just trying to be a pain in the ass, which he's very good at.
Well, game one, it was right there in front of me, so I picked it up and took it. The second time, I had to go a little bit further to grab it, but I don't know if it was to get in the head. I was more just to kind of piss him off, maybe.
I think Chris Pronger's the biggest idiot in the league. I can't stand the guy one bit. I hope I never have to see him again. And if I see him out there, I might punch him.
He said next time he's going to see you, he's going to hit you.
Well, where is that, the minors?
The night we won in Anaheim, all the players went to celebrate. One player went and grabbed the puck. Chris Pronger.
The Anaheim Ducks are the Stanley Cup champions.
And so people said afterwards, oh, he's selfish. So he wanted to get the puck. He didn't celebrate with his teammates. You know what he did with the puck? He gave it to me after the game. So he's got a heart, he just hides it well.
So from this clip with Pronger, we see a few things. First, his clarity in who he is serving. It is not the media, it is not the other team, it is the people in the room, his teammates. And they respect him for that, and they follow him as a leader. Now the second is control. So notice how Pronger mentions how the things he does, the games that he plays, gets other players on other teams off their game. So when you choose the rules, when you choose what to focus on, when you choose what you're in control of, who is really in control of the situation? Well, in this case, it's the player, the person who decides the rules of the game. Now, watch this interaction between McGregor and Jose Aldo. Notice who is visibly upset. and then notice who's playing a game and is actually in complete control.
You're looking at him! You're looking at him! You're looking at him! What you gonna do? 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 What you gonna do?
So now when you watch Laine talk, you might notice how the fun games he plays has him in control because he decides the rules. He's also clear on what he's good at, and clarity and control give him confidence. Now, young players who want to be more confident, like Laine, need to be very clear on their job and what they're good at. Many players are simply unclear on what they're good at and what their job is. Now, in another video, I talk about constructing a player identity using something I call if-then statements. Now, I recommend players do that to become clear on their role. Then players need to be in control to be confident. Now, you don't have to play mind games like Pronger or McGregor, but you can control what you focus on, and control and certainty will help players with their confidence. So what do you think about Patrik Laine's confidence? Is it too much, or is he teaching young players what it is like to be clear and in control? Now, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and share it with a friend. And if there's another type of mindset breakdown that you'd enjoy, and you have some other clips, please leave those in the comments area. And if you're ready to take the next step, why don't you learn how to become a hockey wizard yourself by clicking the button that says become a hockey wizard, because I've prepared a free video lesson for you. I invite you to take part. Thank you for watching today.